I was born in Venezuela. My parents were extremely devout Catholics right up until the time that they died, but they were also very open and accepting people, especially my mother, who had this philosophy that you treat everybody with respect and that you all people have dignity and are worthy of being respected. And that was really important in my own development and thinking. I ended up going to high school in Tampa, Florida, at an all-girls Catholic boarding school. And that's actually the first place where I didn't realize it at the time, but I fell madly in love with my roommate. The nuns realized that I didn't. There was never anything physical, but it was a very, very intense relationship. And in retrospect, you know, I can look back and say, yeah, you know, that's the first woman that I ever fell in love with. But for me, I didn't even know that there were lesbians. I didn't know what that meant. I didn't know anything about same-sex sexual attraction, anything like that. And so other than being incredibly upset when the nuns separated us and wouldn't let us talk to each other or even be in the same classrooms together or sit at the same table during meals, I just knew I was incredibly upset, but I didn't realize what it all meant. Then I ended up coming to St. Louis University for my undergraduate work in biology, and then from there I went to Berkeley. And in Berkeley, one of the things that always sticks in my mind, and still no personal recognition of anything, was that the Newman Center, which was a Catholic sort of university center, had a panel of gays and lesbians who came to speak about their experiences. And for some unknown reason at the time, I decided to go to it. And I was very interested. And I remember walking out and thinking, these people seem so normal. You know, this is not what I thought about people who were gay or lesbian. So I sort of at that point became, I think, a supporter of LGBT people. Just like, you know, those LGBT people over there, but, you know, if anything happens, I would support them, okay? I came to St. Louis, to UMSL, with a job offer, and it was actually while it was, you know, my first few years at UMSL that I began to come to terms with my sexual orientation. And that I started to think, well, gee, is it possible? Maybe I'm a lesbian.